3, 2, 1.
Good morning from South Melbourne.
Good morning, Sir Nigel. How are you?
Very well. Happy to be in the Guitar Colonel's very special Studio One.
Studio One. The den. The den of rock.
And as always, it's been an early pleasure to go out into the showroom and select a weapon of rock. And
That is quite the weapon.
I'm so excited. There is not, you know, and the inner me, I'm a 14-year-old guitarist. There is no 14-year-old guitarist who does not love a Gibson Flying V.
If you've just tuned in, Sir Nigel is holding the Jimi Hendrix Hall of Fame Flying V. So, from 1991,
and it's
before
just,
we were born.
It's just beautiful, and you know, slightly awkward to sit on your knee, but I'm dealing with it. I've got long arms, but
you're doing a great job.
The history of this guitar, it's just mind blowing. All the great players, Albert King, and of course, as we get onto our theme for the day, Grace Potter.
Yes, so yes, that's
you know,
amazing.
If you,
I didn't know that.
I guarantee you, if a Grace Potter Flying V comes into your store,
yes.
Do not put it on the website. Just phone me. The deal is done.
And if Grace Potter comes in as well, clipping my microphone.
Yeah, phone me. But
cool.
I think there's a lot of embarrassing
so Nigel,
moments.
Can you just turn the volume down for just one moment?
There we go.
There we go.
A little less hum.
Yeah. With the new technology,
I know.
You can hear all the buzz.
I feel like I'm in the NASA headquarters here. It's awesome.
It's the NASA of rock here.
It is Cape Canaveral of Studio Rock.
Mm. What's been going on, man? You've been in Perth this week?
Yeah, traveling this week. Perth.
Yep. Mm. How's Perth? I like Perth.
It's a beautiful city. Mm. It's a little depressed after all the Kiwis left and went home again because they've finished all the roads and all the holes and now robots are on the mines. So robots don't need quite as many houses as they used to.
Yes.
So that's good. But as always, travel on the road leaves me yearning for a bit of guitar.
Yes.
And
speaking of Kiwis.
Oh my goodness.
I heard a weird rumor and then I had it confirmed by Neil himself. Neil Finn has joined Fleetwood Mac.
So as my Kiwi house guests, who their wicked senses of humour, Catherine and co, she says it's called Finwood Mac now.
Finwood Mac. Mazia has tuned in. He's an old student of mine.
Fantastic. He probably lusts for one of these as well. I imagine.
He's from Iran. He escaped Iran on camel. With two machine guns.
I think he just went to the airport. He's doing his PhD in astrophysics or something like that.
I think he just went to the airport.
That's good.
Cool.
But that's been a good week and yearning for the rock and roll. So we're going to finish off last week's show. So Lindsey Buckingham fired from Fleetwood Mac, not the first time. I just can't imagine what he said that was so offensive to them that they actually couldn't tolerate it. Like, what does it take to push Fleetwood Mac over the edge and hire a Kiwi to go? And, like, not one guitarist, but two guitarists to replace Lindsey Buckingham. And we've never done any Fleetwood Mac because it's just too hard for me, so...
No, well, you've got to get that... excuse me.
So you got to be finger picking, and you got to be fast on the chord changes.
Finger picking, yes. Well, I'm not sure exactly what he said, but I mean, it can't be anything worse than what he was doing in the 1970s.
No, exactly.
They were out of their minds.
Sex, drugs, and rock and roll.
Mm.
So what do you got today? You've got the good old faithful 335.
Yeah, I'm on the. This is an ES335 from the year 2000. The Y2K guitar.
Yep.
As soon as you turn it on, there's a risk that it may close down the technology grid.
That'll be changing the date and we're all done.
What year is that? It's 2000, year 2000.
Okay, so this is genuinely a 1991 guitar?
That's a 1991 guitar.
So it has sat in its case for...
Pretty much.
I don't know, how many years is that? Nearly 20 years.
Yeah,
because it is mint.
2000, 91, 2000, it's a long time.
It is mint condition.
It's one of 400 as well.
Jeepers. Yeah. I feel very privileged today. Cool. Now, the funny thing about these, of course, and so one of my favourite players of EV, Mr. Davies from the Kinks.
Oh, yes, yes.
But there's some very ugly film footage from the early days in the BBC studio where he plays it like this.
Oh, yeah, up high.
You know, I don't know whether he left his strap at home or he just... They didn't know what to do with it.
I hope he's still got that V, because it'd be worth a lot of money.
Well, Guitar Magazine looks at Vs this way. I picked that up in the airport on my way back from Perth.
Yes.
And it's looking at how do you tell an original V. Like in 69, they made less than 300. They made next to none of these things. They're incredibly rare because they're such a boutique guitar.
Well, by 69, I mean, Gibson wasn't really doing too well, so they didn't make a lot. And now, if you own one, especially an old one, and especially an original one, wowie zowie, that's kind of good. I had a gentleman call me recently to sell a 59 Les Paul.
Oh, the famous.
The famous one. Legit guy.
You're cool that it would be a real one, because there are a few...
No, it's definitely
around.
A real one. He's a man down in Adelaide. It's the one that appears on Jackson's Rare Guitars.
Yeah.
He wants a lot of money for it, though. So,
like 100,000 or something?
Like a lot more than that. Wow. Yeah. So anyway, I'll leave it at that. Yeah. But it's probably not for us. But,
Australia, which is...
There is one in Australia. There genuinely is. He's had it since he bought it in secondhand in 69 or something. So anyway, enough of that shenanigans.
Let's do some rock and roll. I hope you've got some good rockin' ladies music for me today.
Let's do some lady rock. Well, look, Joan Jett. Ooh. You can't go past Joan Jett. I mentioned this during the week to a few people and they said, do the Runaways. And I'm like, oh, come on, no, we got to do I Love Rock and Roll. Yeah. It's the classic one.
Was that the Blackhearts? Joan Jett and the Blackhearts or something like that? There's Joan Jett and the Runaways, the Joan Jett and the Blackhearts, and Joan Jett.
I think so. I think it's the Blackhearts. Joan Jett and the Blackhearts.
I don't know.
Let's have a look at it.
Someone will write in and tell us.
Someone, please.
That's Cunningham's law, by the way. Mm. How do you find out the truth, the correct answer to a question on the internet?
Yes.
Put the wrong answer up and wait 2 minutes.
I like that. It's a
bloke called Wade Cunningham who invented the wiki. That's your trivial knowledge for the day.
And we will do your number one fan. Stalking.
Excellent.
Michael Ray has a request by the Pretenders, so we're going to have a look at that one. We have to do that. That got bumped last week. But
let's play guitar. So
let's do it. Okay, let's check out...
How's our volume levels? Are we all good? Because I've got a giant...
Yeah, that's okay.
Nice.
All right, cool, man. Let's check it out. So Joan Jett, it's essentially a sort of a three-chord rocker in E. Oh, so I'm going to play my E.
Talking my language here.
I like it too. I like it too. Look, and straight away, I'm not going to play E as I normally would. Yeah. So there's my E chord. What's your first finger?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. There's a couple of chords, a couple of open chords that if you have one finger wrong, they sound a bit wacky. E is one, right? If I did this.
It goes A minor. Goes
C is another one.
You
know. That's also. But that's kind of a cool sort of, you know. It's a bit wacky.
Yeah.
It's a bit wacky. Okay, so I'm going to play E in a power chord formation.
Even better.
And I'm going to use the old Jimmy Page, Pete Townsend trick of...
A lot of bass in this guitar, haven't I?
That's okay. Don't do that. Don't touch the red button, sir.
Yeah.
Or you will explode.
Yeah. Okay, that's good.
Okay, so... That sounds good through here. So it's...
So you leave... keep it on the B when you're doing that B?
Yeah, I mean, you play the B and then just... No, you can get out of that B if you want to.
Yeah.
I'm starting to refer... I've been doing jiu-jitsu, and so everything's like, you can get out of that somehow if you just...
Yeah. Escape the B.
Yeah. Learning things like that when you're older is a painful lesson.
It's a good thing to do. One day when you approach your 50s, you'll know that you've had a good payoff for all the things you do.
That's a long time away.
It is. It is.
All right, let's check it out. So we've got the E.
So... Give me a little bit of tutoring on that.
Yes.
Because you're doing way more than a bend there. You're also vibrato.
I'm putting a bit of vibrato onto that. So. Sometimes I tend
fabulous.
To I tend to hit it with an upstroke.
Yeah.
That's a Jimmy Page thing. What's it? Send this thing out of tune. Oh, well, surprisingly right. Good. Okay, so let's try.
Oh.
So okay. That's the main part of it.
So it's already my favorite song of the day because it's only three chords.
It really is only three chords. It's just with a couple of tricks. Saw him dancing there. And now it's really just a shuffle of those chords. So it's, you know, saw him dancing there by the rook of the shore. He must have been about 17. To A. And next we're moving on, he was with me, yeah, me. And next we're moving on, and then B, he was with me. And then it just does this. There's a little riff.
Okay.
Now, we're going to do the harmony. Harmony, folks, is where we play the same thing slightly differently. Okay, so you're going to play this one. So it's a D note. Open the B. Don't put the C sharp in it. So
it's so I'm pulling off on the D to get that.
That's
open.
Right. Yeah. So try it together. 3, 4. So she puts that in. At the end of every turn, right? So saw him dancing there, da 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 da. He must have been 17. We can take you home. So I'm going to try and do the high one, and you're going to do the low one. And the only other part in this, folks, is the solo, which I might have a crack on. There's a little bit of, you know, there's a bit of bending, and I don't have a trem on this guitar because it's a stop tail. Okay, a trem.
Ah.
Or this section here would allow me to go wham, wham, wham and bend the strings, but it doesn't. So if I want to get that, a little bit of bend to it. I'm just bending the neck and the body. Yeah.
Be gentle.
Ooh. Okay, now over that it's just an E to a B. If you can just not, if you don't want to play it, just leave that free. Because I think she's just playing the same, you know. It's something like that.
Yeah.
But anyway, we'll go with it. Hey.
Hey, we'll just, as with all these things, like, we play along, see where it is, see where it goes, pick it up.
You know, it's one of the best things you can do is either put on a drum machine or put on the actual track and play along. And it's just, you realize so many things.
Well, as always,
timing and
tune. You always
and if you're in tune, we sound in tune. I think we're good.
So. No, the bizarre tunings that some of the bands have recorded in over the years that make you suddenly, it's like, no.
Should we do it? Are you ready?
I think we should give it a go.
Let's give it a go. Let's do this, man. Okay, here we go, folks. I have to. Now, I can't get this on Spotify, so I'm going to YouTube for it.
Another good tip, actually, that YouTube live performances where there's less studio fiddle faddle,
yes,
and a little more honest guitaring,
yes,
and you can see how, yes, and you can see where they're playing it on the neck. They've been the source of much useful information over the years for me.
Yes, absolutely. Well, YouTube. Well, I'll tell you what. Let's do this song. We'll come back and we'll talk about learning guitar and the psychology of learning guitar with YouTube.
Okay. Well, let's do it.
My master is better than your master. Okay, I'm going to cut the mics and we're going to do it.
Okay.
Feeling good?
Yeah, let's
rock.
Let's do it.
Here we go, folks. Yeah.